I had the time of my life because I was there on stage with other Commodores and with Lionel Richie, and we were singing Brick House, and it was a glorious moment.
That are times and jokes and a kind of camaraderie that only brothers have.
When you have a hit song out there, let me tell you, the world is your oyster.
In the 1970s, it was hard to believe that there would come a day when the Commodores would stop making hits. That one of the top R&B groups in music history would ever be desperate for a gig. But since lead singer Lionel Richie struck out on his own, the Commodores have struggled for a comeback. And this past May, a down-and-out group shocked their fans when they accepted a $240,000 contract to play in South Africa.
We were going to make money. I will not lie and say we were not. But certainly there were other things we wanted to do. And by virtue of the fact that we were going to make money, we were able then to contribute a sizable amount of money back to the anti-apartheid cause, an amount of money that we otherwise would not, frankly, be able to have contributed.
It was, I think, more greed than anything else. And when you allow money to compromise your integrity, you have nothing left.
On July 14th, Milan Williams, a founding member of the Commodores, was fired. His termination letter said that he had betrayed the group when he squealed to the press about the Commodores' plans to play Sun City.
That's kind of like the gang saying to a member that doesn't want to go down the street and kill the grocery store owner. You know, and he goes and rats on them and tells the cops.
When we were all asked to go to South Africa, Milan agreed to go to South Africa. Just like J.D. Nicholas, Walter Orange, and William King of the Commodores, to do some good for the place. But when the heat, when it got hot in the kitchen, as they may say, when it got hot in the kitchen, he walked out.
Anti-apartheid groups have taken a harsh stand against entertainers who have broken the United Nations cultural boycott put into effect in 1981.
I mean, it's no different than the McCarthy era. How do you blacklist people in 1989?
Perhaps the most surprising fact surrounding the Commodores in South Africa is that a seasoned R&B group actually thought that they could tread on forbidden territory unharmed. For almost two decades, the Commodores have had easy access to every stage in the world. So when they announced their Sun City concert, they were unprepared for the fire of criticism. Black South Africans staged protests, and the Commodores were unable to find one anti-apartheid group willing to take any proceeds from the ticket sales.
I think today we're much, much more aware of the situation in South Africa than we were at the time of accepting that particular date.
Even though the Commodores finally announced that they were canceling their South African appearance, a bitter and hurt Milan Williams is keeping the protest alive. He claims that he had warned the band about the repercussions of playing in Sun City and that they ignored him.
I felt like I was betrayed, not in terms of the fact that they fired me. That's not the point. I was betrayed because I thought that the moral fiber of the individuals in the Commodores was much stronger than that.
I woke up one morning, my phone rang, and someone said, "Have you heard what Milan is saying on the radio?" First time I ever knew about it. To this day, I have never had a meeting with Milan, and he came to me and said, "I am not going to South Africa. I refuse to go. I feel this way about it. I feel that way." Has never happened.
While the Commodores are calling Williams a traitor for taking his complaints to the press, the media has dubbed him a freedom fighter. Yet even with the press by his side, Williams has not received a lot of support from musician friends. Lionel Richie refused to make a public statement in his behalf.
You know, it's that was a little strange. Let me say this tenderly. When the Commodores go out and perform, 90% of that music is music that was written by Lionel Richie. So then you're talking about ASCAP and BMI and royalties and all this kind of stuff now. I think probably the best position for Richie to have taken was to be neutral.
When all of the politics, accusations, and mudslinging are put aside, what you have left is a friendship gone sour. Sometime after the glory days of sold-out concerts and platinum albums, the Musketeers from Tuskegee, Alabama, became aging musicians facing the end of an era.
I cried the day that I realized that I would no longer be with Milan.
I'm still confused about what has happened, the separation of Milan Williams and the Commodores.
There are times with the Commodores that I will never, ever forget. You know, when your best friend hurts you, that's a major hurt. It's difficult to reconcile that because you give your whole self to those people.
Say, Lord, I gave all my money and my time.